Hello friends and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this tutorial, we are going to cover cycle detection in an undirected graph. So, the problem statement is that we are given an undirected graph and we have to check whether it contains a cycle or not. That is, print true if there are one or more cycle or a false if there are none. This type of problem we have covered earlier in case of directed graphs. So if you have seen that video, you may find the approach a bit similar. Let's break down the problem statement further and understand what do we mean by few keyword used here. First, it says that the graph is an undirected one. So what is an undirected graph? Here we see a directed and an undirected graph. Note how the edge of a directed graph is having a direction from one node to another, while the edge of an undirected graph is directionless. Next term we used was a cycle. So what do we mean by a cycle in a graph? Cycle is basically a closed path where we have a sequence of nodes starting and ending on the same node. Here we have an acyclic and a cyclic graph. In cyclic graph, we have a cycle as if we start from zero, we come back to it after going through node 1 and 2. However, in this acyclic graph, if we start from 0, it goes to 1, then 2, and then there is no path that leads back to the node 0. That is, in this graph, we do not have a cycle. Let's now look at the approach to the problem statement. The cycle detection can be done using depth-first search technique. If you are not aware of it, you can go through the tutorial that we had covered earlier. Now, the basic idea is to see that for every visited vertex V, if there is an adjacent U such that U is already visited and U is not parent of V, then we say we have a cycle. Here, parent simply refers to the node from which we are just coming from. We will see the algorithm with the help of this cyclic graph. We will also require a parent variable to keep track of vertex we are just coming from. Also note the representation of unvisited and visited vertex. We start from vertex 0. Initially, all the vertex are unvisited, and since there is no parent of vertex 0, we assign its parent as minus 1. We start our DFS. Since node 0 is unvisited, we visit it. Its neighbor node are 1 and 2. We go to node 1. Since it's unvisited, we visit it, and also note that the parent variable is now 0 as we are coming from vertex 0. Now for 1, the only neighboring node is 0, which is visited and also parent of 1. So we backtrack to vertex 0. Now from 0, the unvisited neighbor is 2. We visit 2, and again, since we are coming from vertex 0, parent remains 0. Now from 2, we have 3 neighbors. 0, which is visited but is parent of 2. 3 and 4, which are unvisited. We move to vertex 3. We visit this node and update our parent variable to 2. Now from 3, we have 2 and 4 as neighbors. 2 is visited but parent of 3, so we move to the unvisited neighbor 4. We mark 4 as visited. Since we are coming from node 3, we change our parent variable to 3. Now from 4, we have 2 neighbors. Node 3, which is visited but is parent of node 4. Also, we have node 2, which is visited but is not parent of 4. Since this was the condition that we have discussed previously, we can say that we have found a cycle. Now let's see the implementation of this modified DFS. This code has been taken from GeeksforGeeks. Initially, we mark all the nodes as unvisited. We then send our starting node to the DFS function. Note that we are sending -1 as parent of the starting node. This loop is to check for all the disconnected graphs. Now, this is the main DFS function. It takes a vertex, the visited array, and the parent variable. It marks the current vertex as visited and checks its adjacent nodes. If adjacent node is not visited, then recur for that node. If visited, then check if it is not same as parent node. If so, return true, that is cycle detected, else return false. Now let's look at the complexity of this code. The code will run in big O of V plus E time. This is same as we have in depth first search. Here V are the number of vertices and E are the number of edges. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.